What's up, fellas? My brothers from another mother, my players, and my abundance cheek slayers. So, fellas, one of my subscribers emailed me that he met this girl at the gym. He's talking to her. All of a sudden, she's hot. Now she's cold. She blocked him on Instagram, but she kept him on Snapchat. So, fellas, let's dissect his email. And after this abundance cheek slaying seminar, hopefully this brother can go dissect some cheeks. So, fellas, without further ado, let's get to this man's email. All right, fellas, let's send a prayer to the cheek-slaying gods. And today, guys, let's fucking make magic happen. Let's fucking do it. All right, fellas, let's get into this. Let's dissect this motherfucker. Okay, so this is his email. So there was this volleyball girl from my college. She's straight up the hottest chick from my school. But generally, I just say something like this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you guys the text message in the next clip. So generally, I just say something like this, what they're up to, and after that, I'll ask them if they want to come over and watch Netflix at my place. Okay? So what do you think I should ask instead? And also, this girl did not seem overly interested. She would send one-word replies on text and Snap. Red flag there, buddy. But I initiated everything at first, and I ended up slaying her cheeks twice in 3 weeks before school ended. Okay? She continued to like my Insta pics a little while after we got sent home from school because of COVID. And 3 weeks later, she unfollowed me from Insta, but kept me on Snapchat. I know this is some simp shit to worry about, but do you think I can still get her back when I get back to school? And do you think my chances are destroyed? All right, fellas. So this is the text message that he sent me that he sent to her. So I want you guys to peep this. He did not even make his approach in the gym. So guys, I really want to break this shit down to you guys because we have a lot of freaking work to do. This is the type of hooligans and the type of bullocks I deal with every single day. This is how I know that this guy does not watch any of my videos. So basically what's going on is, man, this girl is looking at him, he's looking at her, they're pretty much eye fucking each other. Guys, when a girl is looking at you, she is choosing you. She's looking at him and he does not want to approach her. He does not want to make a confident approach. And this is the type of generation of guys we're dealing with. You know what he does? Instead of approaching her, guess what he does? He runs home, goes on his computer, looks up on Instagram, and types in the computer, "Oh, hey, I saw you at the gym today. Oh my god, you're so hot. I'm a little fucking bitch." So, fellas, I always tell you guys, never be afraid to approach women, because if you guys see a girl at a venue, if you see a girl at the gym, if you guys see a girl at the club, and when she's looking at you, she's not looking at you because you look like a damn turtle. She's looking at you because she likes what she sees. When a girl is staring at you, she's giving you choosing signals. Do you guys think a girl will look at a piece of shit and stare at a piece of shit? No, she's looking at him because this guy's a fucking Chad. Let me tell you guys something about women. Women are very indirect. They're not going to drop down on their knees and fucking give you a blowjob and approach you first, guys. What she is going to do is she's going to give off signals. So it's important for guys to pick up on these signals. So the fact that he did not approach this girl, I wouldn't say his game is weak. I would say he's not very confident in his approach. That's what we're here to fix today. Because let me tell y'all something, man. A girl can have a high attraction to you at first, but when she's giving off choosing signals and you don't approach her, you're pretty much sending off signals that you're trying to reject her. And pretty much what you're saying is that my game is weak and I have no confidence in myself. So she can be attracted to you, and all of a sudden, man, she just lost all attraction to you because, you know, you don't have that confidence. So guys, I always tell you guys, it's always good to have that abundance mindset where you don't give a fuck. So in this case, if I was in this guy's position, what I would have done differently, man, is I would not ran home and hop behind my computer and just slide into her DMs. Guys, you have a better success rate with your approach because she gets to see your charisma, she gets to see your confidence, and her attraction level might fucking go skyrocket. So, guys, whenever I'm at a venue, at a club, at the gym, I always have my abundance cheek slang signals antennas high in the sky. So if I see the girl looking at me, guys, what I would do, if I like her, she cannot look like a fucking wildebeest, okay? But let's say this girl is a 10, okay? If she's looking at me, what I would do, man, I'll walk over there. Make sure you excuse yourself because you're interrupting somebody. So what I would have done is I'll walk up over there, make a fucking confident approach, don't give a fuck, walk around like you're the president and shit. So I'll walk over there, I'll be like, "Excuse me, I don't mean to bother you, but my name is Barack Obama. What's your name?" And she'll be like, "Woo, woo, woo." I'll ask her, "You know, what are you working out today?" She'll be like, "Legs." You know, I'll be like, "Okay, is that your favorite muscle to work out?" Talk about the situation. And what I would do is, you know, what you can do is you can give her your number, be like, you know, you know, this is my number. You know, why don't you call me sometime? Maybe we can go grab a drink. Or what you could do is ask for her number and be like, you know, I would love to take down your number. Let's go out for a drink sometime. And then you text her. It's a very simple process. A simple hello can go a long way. A simple hello can get you a girlfriend. A simple hello can get you a wife. A simple hello can get you some cheeks. But guys, what I think a lot of guys are doing, guys, is they're overcomplicating things. They're overthinking about the situation. They're self-sabotaging themselves before the situation even begins. You always gotta walk around like you the fucking stuff, like you fucking own it, be dominant. This is what girls see, how a man walks, how he carries himself. Do you know how attractive it is when a man is confident, when he just walks around like he's the fucking shit? Guys, that is attractive. A man who owns it, the guys who are living a life of abundance, the guys who get after what he wants, guys, that is attractive shit. And the guy who emailed me this, guys, this guy's a very attractive guy. This guy is a perfect example where this guy has all the looks, but the looks does not match the internal. The external is there, but the internal is there. Guys, you always gotta make sure the external matches the internal. You gotta be confident outside and inside. You always gotta be confident in your push where you don't give a fuck. When you get rejected by one girl, man, you meet five more tomorrow. You gotta have an abundance mindset. This is why I always tell you guys to work on the self-improvement, to practice game, work on your charisma, go to the gym, focus on the self-improvement. You gotta make sure the outside matches the inside, the external matches the internal. And just reading this guy's email, what this guy is probably doing is he's probably relying too much on his looks, where, you know, looks get your foot in the door, but it's the charisma and making a girl comfortable is that is what is going to get the panties to drop. So basically, you guys see what he's doing. You guys saw his text message. He's not asking any questions. He's not making her feel comfortable. He's not getting to know her. All he's thinking about is the cheeks. That's where he's fucking up, guys. And he's telling me that he slayed cheeks. Guys, if I was talking to a girl like that, guys, I would not have slayed the cheeks. So let's look at this text message one more time. He says, "What's up?" But there is not once where he asks her questions and wants to get to know her. He asks her for her snap. Guys, this is where he's messing up. You never ask a girl for her social media. You want to ask her for her number because the text messages is a way to set up a date. Use the phone as a tool to set a date, fellas. And let me tell you guys something that's very important. Snapchat, social media, fucking TikTok, guys, all that is a buffer to you slaying the cheeks. It's gonna be a loading sign with three dots. That's what it's doing. You want to use the text message, caller, and set a date. All that Snapchat crap, guys, that is a buffer for you getting the cheeks. So stay away from social media, fellas. And I want you guys to pay attention very closely to this, all right? So when he slides into the DM, do you see how he puts her on a pedestal? He says, "Oh, you're so beautiful," and all that. Guys, that is a huge turnoff for a woman, especially when you're meeting her for the first time. Because I want you guys to understand how a woman dates is she dates up. She wants a guy to look up to. But in this case, the vibes I'm getting off is the guy is like, "Oh my God, you're so beautiful. You're the queen of England. Oh my God, let me just worship you." This is why whenever you're meeting a woman for the first time, you never want to give her any validation, because too much validation leads to masturbation. Like I said, you always want to keep it simple and you always want to be mysterious. Keep your cards tight to your chest where she doesn't know, you know, how you feel or think about her, because a woman likes to discover you over time. Remain mysterious. You understand what I'm saying? And also, I want to touch base on why she blocked him on Instagram and kept him on Snapchat. Guys, when a girl blocks you on Instagram, most likely she has a boyfriend or some dude she's seen on the side. Because let me tell y'all something about Snapchat. All the Snapchat messages, it deletes and it goes away and you can never see it. So, but on Instagram, when you look at the followers and shit, her boyfriend or whoever guy she's seen, he can see who she's following. So he can check that, but he cannot check her Snapchat because all the messages deletes. So the reason why a lot of girls keep guys on Snapchat but unfollows on Instagram or whatever, because these girls need attention. Women need attention because women have very low self-esteem, because when she gets all this attention from guys who look at her story, guys who comments or send her messages, "Oh my God, you look so hot," it gives her a self-esteem boost. So pretty much what I see this guy is pretty much a beta male orbiter who's feeding her attention and boosting her self-esteem. That's how I see it. Because I want you guys to understand that when a woman ghosts you, guys, you are pretty much not her main priority anymore. She's probably found somebody who's more attracted to you, somebody who's more, you know, who knows, who has more confidence, who has more charisma, who can do a better job making her feel comfortable. So fellas, and the I think the third part is, can you get her back? So The thing is, fellas, you gotta stop having a scarcity mindset where you're just so focused on one girl, because this can lead to one-itis. One-itis is an unhealthy obsession with the girl. You gotta have an abundance mindset where you don't give a fuck, because if she fuck with you, I'm telling you, she'll make effort. But now she's gone, she's probably talking to some other dude. So what you have to do, man, you always gotta keep prospecting. You always gotta keep an open mind where you're talking to multiple chicks. What I like to call this is spinning plates, because if you're so focused on one girl, guys, this is going to cause neediness. This is going to cause, like, bad obsession. So you want to date multiple people at once. So stay in a level of abundance. And the only time where you pursue the relationship is when she asks you, what are we? Because you want a girl to pursue the relationship. Because if a girl is pursuing the relationship, she's chasing you, you will never lose her. And you also got to understand that never be in a scarcity mindset with women. You have to understand that some girls are going to like you and some girls are not. That's just how life works. You're not fucking Justin Bieber and you're not Leonardo DiCaprio. You understand what I'm saying? Me and you guys, we have to just live with what we're dealt with. Just be in a level of abundance. And fellas, and the next question is, can you get her back? You can't. But the only way you can get her back is you have to let her come to you. You cannot chase her. Because when you chase her, man, it just shows that you're needy, you just want her, and that's unattractive. You let her come to you. And if she does not come to you, man, fuck, we on to the next. Abundance mindset. You cannot obsess over one girl, because obsessing over one girl, guys, it's unhealthy for you. It can really fuck up your mind, and it can really, really, really lead to bad things in life. So, guys, this is all I have to say. So, when you talk to girls, guys, always be in a level of abundance and make her feel comfortable. Guys, you have to get her mind before you slay the cheeks. You have to, what's that word I'm looking for? You have to get inside her head before you get her in the bed. Fellas, another thing is, if you want to have more charisma with a girl, man, you gotta have an abundance mindset where you don't give a fuck. Because when you don't give a fuck, you can speak your mind a lot easier. That's where the charisma comes from. That's where the charm comes from. I discussed this so many times. So, fellas, tell me what you guys think. Tell me if this happened to you guys before. Comment what you guys think down below. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. And don't forget to share this with a friend, because, you know, everybody can use the Abundance Cheek Slang Seminar in their life. So, fellas, like I said again, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, like, comment, subscribe. I'm out this motherfucker.